There are 14 temples between Abu Simbel and Philae, to say nothing of grottos, tombs, and other ruins. I am never bored by them. And to explore, to write and testify that I am here. And this isn't Islington, this isn't come, let's leave Abu Simbel, you and I. The boat awaits. Boat and crew. The passengers are three. The idle man, the painter, me, are here to see the sights, to say that we are here, and that this isn't Islington. No! Like the native, says the idle man, who, like his river, shows us nothing and hides its violence beneath, so says the idle man.
How English, then, this Nile,
I say,
to show.
The crew is running short of breath. It gets hotter every day.
Look on a pen field. Saint Islington. This is the
I'm in here for the heat. Not for the art, but for the cool. New York in June. Jesus! What's with the suggested donation? Less donation, more AC is the suggestion I'm donating. The Empire State Building. Great view, but the fucking lines were brutal. Broadway. You won't find me paying that much for some shitty play. Ellis Island. That was cool, though history's not my thing. Got some great shots of Lady Liberty, though. You wanna see? Central Park. Awesome. Shot some kids playing ball. Funny, at home I'd never shoot them. Here it feels exotic somehow. Different. My girlfriend said that I should totally, definitely check out the Guggenheim. So I hauled myself up here. This heat. But it's like $20 just putting a toe through the friggin' door. Forget it. Man, forget it. The building's totally awesome, though. Got some great shots. Check them out.
Crocodiles come out to lie in the sun. men rest on their oars. That breaks the spell.
I'm out of memory.
They spring, plunged out the bank, are gone. In a moment.
Amazing.
The idle man lets us pass without a shot. He wants no part in their demise.
Can see tomorrow. True, all you have to do is to imagine. Look beyond us now in 1963.
In the street!
Like temple halls with hieroglyphs on our Egyptian earth. And we, Egyptian engineers like me, the whole wide Western world be damned. We'll build a monument as grand as any Ramses built on Nile bedrock or on silt.
There has been a revolution
in the streets of Cairo,
an Arab world
with Arab rule
in the streets of Cairo. This dam at Aswan will free us from all time, from need, from war, from hate. We will regulate, control these waters, build a structure that if one day a man could go to space, he could look back and trace, carved out in blue against these desert sands, what engineers like me and unskilled hands dug and hauled and moved and built a sea.
One night, along both banks.
In Nubia.
I forget where.
Ibrim Wadi Sabua.
Here.
Fire and drum.
In Nubia.
Torches.
Men are different. Proud and tall and strong.
The night's a
light.
It is beautiful.
Beautiful, but
we are
brutal.
Warned against it.
Angry.
At every stop along the banks, they come.
The men have left their towns,
women
have left their homes. Even from the Delta, they come to join this great work.
They sit upon the banks and stare at us for hours.
It's beautiful.
The men, savagely. The women,
follow with children,
dressed in beads and rings.
Boys with five chameleons, girls pester us with trinkets.
All families,
dance,
proud and fierce and
beautiful,
celebrate with labor,
when we go away.
Shoulders to the wheel.
Real life,
Arabs,
black and cold and busy as
ants, from Russia.
roll their pellets of earth
and barge
up
and
the
row
water's
and
edge.
Ram.
Pick this up at the gift shop. Pretty neat. It's got lots of pictures. And check this out.
A native sells the idle man a necklace.
For my girlfriend. Pretty sweet.
He goes away content.
Not cheap, nuh-uh. But hey, I like her.
He comes back later. Half the village at his heels, asking double price.
No way, no way could I refuse.
The idle man refuses. The native rages. Wild, he throws his spear, tears off his turban. This, it seems, is Nubian for a challenge.
This is Nubia.
The crowd is restless. The crew is worried. The idle man is unaware. He reads the scriptures down below deck.
Where once from Egypt, Greece, and Rome they came to civilize a culture savage, different from their own, to bury it with book and Bible, force and fear. Obliterate the pagan, install their own gods here.
I send a note to the accuser.
To watch their world submerge beneath the weight of time.
And then, a most unnatural thing. A silence falls upon the crowd. They wait until the promised hour of prayer is past. And when the idle man emerges, all is well. He talks to his accuser, offers the trinket back for monies paid before and pressed into that hand, that cup, that claw.
This is Nubia, neglected, begging back their men, dispersed by flood and famine.
But now the man, his fury spent, prefers to hold his bargain and departs content.
Whole towns of women and dying men laid out like flotsam in the dust or propped against their door.
What better way to show her
this is a proof
that culture's not a foreign land to me?
That love of spirit, call it justice, moves in Sammy's savage man.
No culture left in Nubia, no building, temple, home, or shrine.
Thus it will prove
it moves against the odds
that I was here,
I was.
Only the young, the infant, and the old remain to testify that they were there. They were.
And she will be like you were there.
This is the price of progress.
Bingo.
And there the river turns and comes to Dendur.
Thank you. Yeah.
taste chills upon the air. Supplies are low. The crew is hungry.
Hungry,
says our own cook.
Nothing to be done. There's just enough for you. Of course they're hungry. They're Arabs. And Arabs bear hunger as camels bear thirst. They've been hungry before. They'll be hungry again.
We find ourselves reduced to five.
The cook,
his boy Mehmet, and I.
The idle man.
The painter, too. There is nothing to do. The painter paints. I sketch in words and ink.
The idle man.
With Mehmet as retriever.
Slinks off to shoot. A level aim. I fired. A woman and a child were squatting in the barley, and quail fly low. They skim the surface of the grain and dive and disappear. Up they spring. Mother and child screaming. A gang of men coming toward me. Someone took my gun, tore it from me. See here, you can see the place they struck me, tore me, blood.
The woman is unhurt, the child only slightly.
I want my gun.
Teeth are bare.
Assault.
A siege along the riverbank.
Call the village to account. Brutality must be avenged.
Return
Up. We wait. Ashore, the faces flash and burn, all scorn and anger, all defiance. Then, as if a wave had come, or the waters of a flood had drained between the plain earth exposed, the crowd begins to sit.
And when a Nubian sits, you can be sure he is no longer dangerous.
Looking out onto the bank, the masked people blank in their aggression, or I don't know who is more afraid, they or us. The gun was returned, laid down on the bank like some religious icon of a forgotten tribe. No one moved for an eternity, it seemed. And then I barely saw the ripple at first. An old man parted the crowd, moving toward the river's edge in silence. He stood staring up at the boat, a bundle wrapped in blue cloth in his arms. A plank was put across. He bent down and picked up the gun. The crew fingered their weapons. I felt for the silver chain that held a locket around my neck and felt instead a fluttering pulse betraying me. The man with gun and bundle moved up the plank. The crowd shifted toward the boat, but were held at bay. On deck now, he unwrapped the layers of blue cloth, laying the bundle down, to reveal a little brown child about 4 years of age with shaven head. He whimpered at first, seeing our strange white faces, but when a fig was offered, forgot his terrors. His wounds were slight, skin deep, leaving an imprint of fine, gentle rust on the cloth. The shot had grazed his shoulders. The idle man solemnly sponged the scratches with warm water, then covered them with sticking plaster. Finally, we offered the man, his father, protector, a single Napoleon, which seemed to suffice as recompense, atonement for those we trespassed against. The patient, now wrapped in one of his assailant's shirts, departed, disappearing into the vortex of men and women on the bank. And calm descended. At least, for now.
Were here.
cut a tomb into the rock at Dendur. Into the rock we carved a holy place and wrapped their swollen forms in sheets of linen, the color of the evening sky. There are no songs for this. There are no words. There are no temples built by Caesar on the western bank that can replace a child. There are no songs, my God's were boys. My God.
Excuse me, sorry, no video. Please, no video.
Christ! They, the mob, my back was turned, defenseless. What savage attacked me from behind. A rock, a blow, blood on my shirt, Egyptian cotton, torn. I have my rights, the blow, the blood, and justice is my right.
The right of any man to travel through an alien land
unharmed.
He went,
the idle man,
to see the governor.
That, madam, would be me.
Charming.
As ever.
I want justice.
No doubt you do.
Not for me, but for all future travelers.
Ah, I see.
They should not suffer such indignity.
Stolen our men.
We have 15 of them behind bars.
You.
Not me.
I had nothing to do with it. All is in the hand of justice.
There is no law.
no one to intercede on our behalf. Just us. Just you.
He went.
Again.
The idle man.
To see
the governor.
Charming.
As ever. Coffee?
But 15 men
have been brought in, it's true. And 14 have confessed that number 15 is the guilty one.
I see.
What would your excellency like to see?
I don't know your laws.
Your sentence.
The idle man's perplexed.
How can a sentence be pronounced before the trial?
But your excellency, this is the trial.
Justice.
One month in jail, the guilty one, 2 months.
Whoa! 1816, 1818, 1820, 21, 1872, and 88, and check this out! In 1891, some guy from New York, some dude, Mr. Brat, Leon, Lionel, Larry, who knows, was here and carved his name into the stone. Pretty neat. No fading. No abrading of his sharpie in the stone or time. He was here and still is here. He is with Leonardo and with Maddox, with T. Scardeo. And Amira Belmore, and Matesi? Who were these guys?
Who was lost to heat, to war, to age, to
which one is the Idleman? Adrift and floating down an ancient river in a brutal foreign idle land. The
from space will
drown your sorrows, Nubia.
10,000 years of those who've walked this
the
ground
you come and cease to be.
Those who lost their lives to mortal hate, to some malady from gods or man, those who built a house of mud, a temple, shrine, a place to leave their mark, will drown and be submerged by time or progress. They'll leave no sign upon this land, beyond a brilliant shining sea, a liquid fossil caught in sand.
This is the
against the odds, what now is lost to waters lapping at the feet, the throats, the crowns of
the gods. Rising from the deep have come again to haunt your land and bless
and see, yes.
It has been a hot day. There is dead calm on the river. Not a breath, not a bubble. Troubles an inverted landscape. Temple has turned.
Thank you.